My name is Omri Gillath, and I'm a social psychologist in the psychology program here at KU. We're trying to understand how we can enhance or increase generosity. And while doing it, we're trying to understand what generosity is in a way. So we start with a very simple definition of generosity as the virtue of giving, basically. It's giving money or resources or time to other people. And from there, we're trying to understand what are the kind of like underpinnings, what are the brain mechanisms that would help us to understand generosity. We don't know much. That's the reason for why there are now more and more projects focused on generosity. So we do know that some people tend to give. We do know that it depends on kind of like the environment and how, whether or not other people are looking at them. We do know that it depends on modeling. So if your parents used to give, you are more likely to give. And we're going to try and first of all just ask people using surveys and kind of like interviews what they think about generosity, what kind of generous behavior they exhibit, what kind of things they do that they think would fall into this category. After getting some of the answers, we're trying to find a correlation or kind of like similarities between how they talk about their close relationships and how they behave in family, with friends, with a significant other, and how they talk about giving in general to others. What we're hoping to find from this step is a connection between how secure you feel with close others, what we call attachment security, and how generous you are. And the more secure you are, we expect that the more generous you'll be. Then, once we have that, we're going to do the kind of like the cognitive and physiological levels that you mentioned before. One of them is using decision-making games or tasks, where basically we'll get people to come in and play with other individuals, and we'll give them a certain amount of money, and then we'll have to decide whether they want to give the money away or keep it to themselves. And we're going to look at their behavior. And finally, we'll do the same kind of game, but while we're measuring their brain activation. So we'll try to see if we can detect what are the brain mechanisms that are involved or the brain processes that are involved in their decisions. So whether you feel, for example, good or bad about giving money away, and how do you feel about losing the money, right? If you gave it away and the partner in the interaction didn't kind of like give it back, how do you feel about it? Because we expect generosity not to be dependent on getting back from others. We got the grant from Notre Dame, and they have a center that is focused on generosity, and they're trying to not just to progress science, but they're also trying to make it a better place, you know, a better world. And so that you know, makes us feel really generous about what we're doing, right? In a way, we're not just trying to understand something better, we're also hoping to have an effect on society.